Awesome. So good afternoon, good evening, good morning, everyone, wherever you are joining for the session today. So with the Azure Community Singapore, we're going to have another session with a great speaker. So our great speaker today is actually joining from long away from the Romania. So I would really thankful for you to, you know, joining us from long away. So, and yeah. So we're gonna get started the session today, and then so today we're gonna discuss about Roslyn Source Code Generators. So without further ado, let's get started. Over to you, Andrew. Andrew, you are, I think you are on mute.
Sorry, I was on mute, indeed. I was starting to present. Okay, thank you for the invitation. I want to introduce myself and then I will present the agenda. So my name is Andrei Ignat and I am a Microsoft MVP for Developer Technologies. I am a programmer for 20 years. And today I will be speaking about Roslyn Source Code Generators. And this is very new, very interesting, and had grabbed my attention deeply, because what can be more fulfilling for a programmer than someone wrote the code for you? But let's see the agenda for today. So the agenda for today, it's about me. What is Roslyn Source Code Generators? I will show you some examples, some simple examples, and then I show you some examples of others that have been made the Roslyn Source Code Generator that can help you, that help me, and maybe they will help you. So the presentation will have two distinct parts. One is how to create a Roslyn Source Code Generator if you want to create one, and you can ask me any questions. And the second part will be, look, these are the Roslyn Source Code Generators that are already made and can help you in the developing application. So this is about me. I have a blog. I am a ASP.NET forum moderator. I have a YouTube channel that I post some .NET tools. And I have written some books for Amazon. That one book that I'm very proud of, it's a book of copy-paste from Stack Overflow. How do you copy-paste from Stack Overflow? If you do not know, it is a book for this. And the Roslyn Source Code Generators, I have made a GitHub with Roslyn Source Code Generators examples, the one that grabbed again my attention, and this is where we'll be speaking today. So, for the start, what is Roslyn Source Code Generator? The Roslyn Source Code Generator is another program that grabs the result of the compilation, add more source code to the compilation, and then the .NET build resumes. So this image will show you how it is in practice. So in practice, you have Visual Studio or .NET build, the command line, that runs the compilation. You compile your program. Then you will have a source code generator that resizes the results of this compilation, can analyze the source code. After this, we'll generate the new source code. This red part is where the Roslyn Source Code Generator is. And when you create a Roslyn Source Generator, you will generate this new source code based or not on the previous source code. And then this source code, it's added to the compiler, and this compiles, and this is how it is done. So you'll add some new source code based on a previous source code if you want. So now it's the time for a demo, because all my presentation are with demos, are with real examples. But now we'll have a demo about how to create a simple source code generation. So, and debug this. So for the moment, let's see the source code. And as I said, the source code is here. I will let you the link at the final of the presentation. You'll have the presentation and the source code for everything that I present here. Okay, good. So let's start the demo. In the demo here, We have a Roslyn Source Code Generator, very simple, a project that is called very simple. And we have a console write line hello world, because if you want to make something, you make a hello world, and put my test write date. As you see here, it's not a my test class. If you see here, it's not a my test class. It's a simple generator, but it's not a my test. How this my test write date is coming? Let's start this program, set the start project, see that it's compiling, and it writes the date. See, hello world, and write date. How it's happening, this magic? Again, so what we have a simple generator. A Roslyn Source Code Generator, it's a .NET Standard 2.0 program. This is what it is for the moment. And must include these DLLs, these NuGet packages, code analysis analyzers and code analysis C#. More, if you want to generate something, you decorate with generator attribute and you implement iSource generator. And when you implement the iSource generator, let me press F12. These are two things that you should implement, initialize and execute. I will concentrate on execute and how the my test is coming. So we have here a text, a simple text that says using system public class my test with the right date. And I put system debugging diagnostic break to break the things and console write line date time now to string. And in the execute function, we have the context, the generator execution context that Microsoft is giving to us. And we can add source and we put a name, mytest.cs, and text. This is for diagnostic, we'll see later. So what is happening is that the compilation runs, so the Roslyn very simple console program will run, it will compile. Then, because it has seen that it has the project reference to the Roslyn Source Code Generator with output time item analyzer, it will go, and is this part here. It will go to execute this one. In the context, we'll see later, we'll receive everything for the initial program. Okay, and then the text is there, and it will be added. And this is, then the compilation will resume and will compile the things written here, so the my test with write date, and we can call it without problems. If we want to see the result, we can expand the dependency analyzer, and you'll see here the class my test. Here you'll see that the file is auto-generated by the generated program and cannot be edited. So it says you cannot edit this one, it's automatically generated. You cannot edit like in this case of the usual program. Okay, here I said, where are the files? In the first moment that the Roslyn Source Code Generator were invented, Visual Studio was not so good to see them. So you have put this kind of stuff, emit compiler generated files, and compiler generated output path to see them somewhere. Now it's not need to have this kind of stuff. Microsoft has improved both Roslyn Source Code Generator and Visual Studio. If you have the version 16.10.3, I think that 10.1 it's good, but I do not know now. But if you update to the latest, you will see here. Also, how you make debugging this kind of Roslyn Source Code Generator. It's when it was in the first stages, it was system diagnostic debugger break, and also in the Roslyn Source Code Generator, it was debugger launch and you attach to the process. Now it's simple like this. You click properties, you say here, you see here debug, and you say you have the simple generator that launches a Roslyn component, and the target project that will benefit by the augmented code, it will be the Roslyn generator, very simple. So basically, when you have a Roslyn Source Code Generator, you have the generator and the output program where it will be, the code will be written augmented there generated. And we can debug very simple. I have put here the breakpoint, I launch, and now, after some time that it's building, okay, this is the program, sorry for this. I didn't put as a startup. Let's put the code generators as a startup to interrupt there, F5. So the compile is going. The compilation of the program didn't finish yet. If I look to the output, it doesn't finish. It goes to my Roslyn source code generator, like this image. I have in the context, we see later, everything from the initial program. Then we add this source of using system my test. We can have a diagnostic to be reported. And now the execution resumes and the program has been compiled. And this is how you debug the Visual Studio code generator. So what I need here to say is how we see what is happening and we can be writing logs. We have the do diagnostics. So if you see in the compilation, usually with this kind of stuff, you should say build rebuild solution. And you will see here in the error list, the warning here, this is a warning that I have put here. So to create one Roslyn source code generator is so simple. You have a .NET Standard 2.0 project. You will have this is Roslyn component to true to can debug. And if you want to write something, you have the context report diagnostic. To the context that it's coming via execute to the interface as source generator, you can put anything into the text to be added there. This is about how you create a Roslyn source code generator. Okay, if you have question, you put on the YouTube channel and I will recite here on Teams. Okay, next. Next, we'll have some simple generator examples. Simple generator examples comes from, so let's say from the files. So let's say that I have a JSON file that I want automatically to generate from the JSON file to generate the C# class. You've done this many times before, but now it's a Roslyn source code generator. Why is this good? Because if you want, in time, you can add more properties to the JSON class. And after this, the C# will be generated automatically and improved with the new properties. But let's see an example. Let me go to the examples. Again, all these examples you will see into the my presentation that you can download. So here is the example. So we have a person JSON with first name, last name, and blog. I have put there my blog because it's free advertising, and my name also because of the JSON. I can have my name there. So we have a person class, person JSON, sorry, I have a person JSON, and I have put a person class. This class is partial. What it means by partial in C#, that means that you can have another partial definition of the class. This partial definition of the class will be automatically generated by a Roslyn source code generator that is called JSON by example generator. This is made not for me, it's another guy that has made, you can find on Nuget. And you'll see that I have put just partial class person that says full name. It is first name plus last name. And here in program, I say var p new class person. I have put new blog. And how this full name access first name and last name if they are not seen? Let then C build, reveal solution in order to make, I want to make everything sure that it's okay. And now we see that in the analyzer, in the JSON one example generator here, unfortunately is not yet a Roslyn source code generator. It's put into analyzers, but I think that will be solved. And we have a person generated, and this again is generated by a tool. And here we have first name, last name, blog. We have another thing that the guy provided to us. It's a from config thing, so it has provided more information. Again, what we can do is, if I go to the person JSON and I put here age, let's say age, and I put 51 and I save. Now, if I go to program, I can say p1 dot, and you see that age has appeared, equal 52. And in this way, you see here the age has appeared and it's generated. And in this way, you can modify the JSON and you'll generate automatically the class. Think about now about upsettings from .NET Core, ASP.NET Core. If you modify there, the new class will come with the properties. More, this guy has put an I configuration here to can load automatically. So in the program, what I have a configuration builder that I add the JSON file and put config get person. So I can get a person from config. It's something that everyone wants one day. Grab an app settings to make a class from the JSON settings. I think that you like the demo, hopefully. Let's see what I have next. Interacting with code examples. So first example was just a moment to see if on the meeting team, no. First example was generating code from zero. This is generated code, the thing that I have shown to you is generating code from a JSON. Now see how we generate code from existing code. Let's see an example else. Code, source generator, okay. Generator demo, just a moment. Interacting with code, this is the one. Let me open it. Okay, let me build a rebuild solution. Okay. That's all up to date and see what we have in program. So you see that we have a class person, F12. Sorry for this. Let's go here. The class person has an ID, first name, last name, and the full name. But this class person do not have a destructor. A destructor, that means maybe I want to grab the file by the properties. So we have here the deconstruct that it's deconstructing the class on its properties. So the class has an ID, a first name and the last name, and we automatically generate the deconstruct with ID, first name and last name in order to obtain this kind of stuff. Also, this class F12, let me show you the initial class. It has just first name, ID, last name, and full name. ID, first name, and last name as the properties. It doesn't have a copy constructor. The Roslyn source code generator can see what are the properties of your class and generate a copy constructor for you. Let me press F12 here. And you'll see here the partial class that it's auto-generated. And here you have a public person with person other, so a constructor that it's constructing the person from another person and has copy properties. And the copy properties, it's generated and copied ID, first name and last name without reflection. So you do not need to ask the class and provide type, get properties and see what are the properties and copy one by one. This is made generated automatically from the existing source code. How is done this? It's done this with the auto methods. It's another source, Roslyn Source Code Generator. This is made by me and says, you have a custom template file. And in this custom template file, the copy constructor, it will generate the code by this copy constructor TXT. And this copy constructor TXT says, we have copy properties from, and we put the class name and say, for each property, put this property equal other. So if I modify here and I put Andrei, or say Andrei copy property, and I put the name of the property, now you will see that the Roslyn Source Code Generator has been modified. Let me show this. So say Andrei copy property and ID, Andrei copy property first name, Andrei copy property and last name. So this is another example of Roslyn Source Code Generator that will take your properties from the class and based on a template will generate everything you need for a copy constructor. So this is an example how Roslyn Source Code Generator interacts with existing code. This code, it's already written about the person and you just add the AOP methods common and generator and make these auto methods with a custom template file and the code will be generated for you, for your properties, for your methods, for everything. Okay, let's go next. Interactive code examples. And we have here also enum and mock. Let me show you enum and mock. For testing, just a moment, enum. 12. So, what we have an enum state, F12. Sorry. Enum. Just a moment. We have an enum that it's called state. They have none, active, and wait. So it has three values. And I have put again a template here with a Roslyn Source Code Generator that says enum txt. What will do this kind of stuff? For the moment, we'll generate a state and we'll generate, let me show you here, a key values pair. What is a key values pair? It's a dictionary that contains the values of the enum. So we have none, we have active, and we have wait. If we add to the existing enum, another, just a moment to go there, state, F12, and we add another value, let's say test equal 3. And we start compiling. After this, you'll see that the key value dictionary that will contain the values of enum has been improved with test and with values of the test. So this is something that if you want to iterate in the enum, you can do automatically. This is code generated, auto-generated by this enum.txt that you can add there everything again that you find valuable. Exactly, I have put here parse exact state. I have put here parse exact state that it's giving a long value with a default value, and parse exact state with a string value. And this is comparing, one by one the properties with the string. So theoretically, it will be very fast, and the string compare, it's a string comparison, invariant culture, ignore case, because I found this variable to can compare it. And it can return a default value, or it can throw an argument exception for this. It's your choice how you want to return the code, because in an enum.txt, you can modify this kind of code and just not throw an argument exception, just return something that you want. Again, the possibilities are very large. So the mock instance, let me see if it's here. No, just a moment into the presentation. Okay, I do not find the mock for now. Okay, it's here, sorry for this. So the mock, usually when you have test, you want to create mocks for every dependency that you want to create. This is automatically created by, let me show you here the name, is this mock source generator. This mock source generator says, I will interpret your code, and you say something that it's a person mock. So if you end with mock on the class and you put new, I will create from zero for you from the interface that you want. So this interface, iPerson, F12, first name, last name, and full name. And the Roslyn Source Code Generator, this mock, sorry, just go again, the mock source generator will interpret the person mock, will see the function that I'm in person, and will generate the function for us. So let's see how this person mock looks, F12. You see here this file, it's auto-generated. And you see that has mock first name and has the first name. It has the ID, the last name, and the full name. So he has generated everything that he's shown into the iPerson. So let's see that I put here and in the partial class also, public, because it's implementing iPerson, public string name of me. And I add this name of me to the interface. I will save. I will build rebuild solution. Usually you'll make rebuild solution to have it. Okay, it comes another error because here, let me, here the deconstructor will have another argument. Build rebuild solution. Okay, and now we'll see the person mock, and the person mock here has also name of me. The new value that I have added to the person, he is generated for us in order to have this mock full and can mock any kind of interface that you want. It's something that is very straightforward and can be a lot of fun to just add to the interface something, and it's a mocking class just generated for you as you want. Okay, good. Let me see on Teams some questions. No, okay. So now we'll pass to the latest thing on the Roslyn Source Code Generator, that it's observability and traceability from the software. So what I want to say is that logging for us, it's a thing that we must do, but because we want to see in the production what it has, but it's not so nice to have and put logging everywhere to know where where the bug it is and what's the problem. So this Roslyn Source Code Generator can help us with this kind of stuff. What I will do, I will have a little program that it's a .NET Core API that I will instrument without modifying very hard the source code, and all it will work as usual. And more than this, we'll have whatever logging we want. For my logging, I have used the Jaeger, and you will see the results right away. In just a moment. So the code is here. Stack tracing, auto tracing, and this is the code. Okay, I will start Jaeger in order for you to see. I use Docker for this. Docker is something that let me run any kind of programs that has HTTP interfaces. And we'll see in Jaeger that we do not have anything there. Okay, so this is Jaeger. Here it's not a service. Nothing there. Let me search auto. Auto. I think that we are clear. Good. We launch the program. It is very simple. We have a person controller that has search and load data, F12. This search and load data awaits a search full name, then loads the some details, then have more load details, then find depths, has an HTTP call client to the bing.com. So it makes everything here. So how we know what function is there and how we add automatically logging to this kind of stuff. Let me put it, try it out from Swagger, execute. And this Jaeger is going us with auto tracing, find traces. And you will see here that auto tracing with 12 has the auto tracing with just my data source and Bing. We do not know from all this kind of code with search full name, load details, everything there, find depths, where the program is, has been going, where it has the error, what it is. It's kind of difficult. What I have been done is adding a Roslyn Source Code Generator. The Roslyn Source Code Generator, it's again AOP methods common method generator. This is the source code generator. And what is happening in the CI when the code is being built on the continuous integration server, it's modifying all the public methods with auto. So I put here auto. I put here auto. This will be a simple PowerShell that will put everything that it's public with auto. Okay, and auto. And you'll bet that if I put auto, the code will not compile. Surprise, it will compile. The search and load data, this one, F12, it will be auto-generated, a Roslyn Source Code generator that will be search and load data, and it will have improved here with logging, and here we'll call the auto method. So let's start again with Notepad because I want to explain how it's done. So we have a method load data that it's called from the controller. Load data. What is happening? We put the controller, we'll have the method load data called. But the method load data is not existing anymore. It's auto load data. And from auto load data, the Roslyn Source Code Generator will generate the load data method that is the same name as the before. So this is phase 2, modify load, load data in auto load data. So the controller will call load data and generator creates load data plus logging and calls auto load data. And the controller calls as usual load data, that this is the new one generated by the generator, and this is logging and calling auto load data. So if you put this kind of stuff into a continuous integration server like TFS, like Azure DevOps, like GitHub Actions, like CircleCI, Travis, and so on, with a simple PowerShell that renames the name of the method, you will see how the code will react now. So what we have now, when we call, let me call with Swagger again, try it out with 12, execute. What we'll have now with Jaeger, let me go back. Instead of having just 4 spans here, if I go with find traces, you'll have here 12 spans. And we'll see that search and load data calls search full name, calls load details many times, and here you'll have the stack trace how the methods are called. So first it's search full name that takes this time. And this is right, because if I go to the auto load data, just a moment, some controller, personal repository, auto search and load data, you see that it's waiting for a full name. Then it has load details. It has here the load details that it's called approximately synchronously. Asynchronously, it's awaiting each one. And then it's called in parallel with the select load details. You'll see here the, okay, the load details, it's here. I didn't see now, but it may be an error here. It's find dates, it's here find dates, and load details has been finished. This is why it doesn't call. But you'll have a stack trace of your graphical stack trace of your methods, what is there, what is having been an error. And you see here the search and load data called search full name that calls my data source. If you look at the previous thing with the 4 spans, let me see the operation HTTP get with the 4 spans, you see just the my data source has been an error. If you go here with the tracing, it will be everything generated there. So what I want to show you is that with small modification that can perform by a continuous CI, the code can be augmented. And just let me show you how much it's augmented. So it has augmented with a caller member name to see from which member it has been called, with a file path, with a line number. It goes to the current activity, and it's called the method class, and it's putting the class, the UTC date start, the user, everything there. Then if it's exception, it's adding the event of errors. You can put serilog also. You can put everything here that you find valuable for you to add logging to everything that you want. It just has to be a code convention that you'll respect. So this is the demo with stack trace and Roslyn Source Code Generator and open tracing. Here are the links to be started. And what I want you to stress here is that this Roslyn Source Code Generator is not a dead end. It's just starting. And Microsoft for .NET 6 that will appear, I think, in November, it has put here that .NET 6 with JSON serializer will have source generation available. Why? because it's easier rather to make reflection and iterate between properties to have a build time. When it's building the project and you say, I want to serialize this class, to inspect what you want to serialize, what are the properties there? And I serialize just the properties. I do not use reflection. And the logging also will be made with this one. The links here to get started is how you create a Roslyn Source Code Generator for yourself, for others to be used, anything like this. So if you want, again, to see more Roslyn Source Code Generators in examples, you will have here on HTTPS, ignatandrei.github.io, Roslyn Source Code Generator example. This is the link. You'll find more examples there. I do not want to share the fun, but it is very fun to see the code is generated from your code. So I do not know if you have question. I will look now on Teams. Okay. Sorry, I said that .NET has code generator since 2.0. How is Roslyn Source Code Generator different? I do not know what you mean by the fact that has code generator. It has been analyzers. Analyzers have been analyzed the code and provide suggestion of how the code has been improved. This code generator is generating the code without the user making an action. I think that this is what you want to ask. I have been knowing that it has code generator. If you look, speak about T4 templates, this is very different from T4 templates. Now I've seen that you were speaking about T4 templates. The T4 templates doesn't allow you this kind of stuff. So the T4 templates do not interact with the existing source code. So you cannot have the current compilation that is coming here to be analyzed and generate new source based on this. So this is the new thing that it's here. So as you see, I have modified my method with auto. I have analyzed this method and generate a new method that says search and load data with what you want. This kind of stuff with the previous code generators with T4, it was very hard to do. Now it's easy because, let me show the first example. Okay, just a moment. Just a moment in the code, in the very simple here. File. Open. Here in the generation execution context, in this kind of class, you will receive the compilation. And the compilation is the program that was being compiled before. Here is the program CS, the console application. And we can access his classes, ask his classes about the methods and everything there. So I think this is the kind of new that we have, that the current program is already analyzed by this kind of stuff and generated. I hope that I answer your question.
Yeah, okay. I think there's no more questions. Please. Coming. I'll be waiting for a couple of minutes, right? Maybe 1 minute. So guys, if you have any questions for Andrei, just shoot them right in the chat window. So at the same time, I would like to, you know, remind you that I have already posted the presentation link. So just go up a little bit to the chat window and then you can see the presentation link. So if you cannot find, just a message in the chat window. Okay, let's give a couple of 1 or 2 minutes for you to, you know, give us any questions. Okay, I think no questions from the audience. So, yep. So All right, so with that, guys, thank you everyone for joining the session today. And also, I'm really grateful we have our good speaker, Andrei. So thank you so much for joining all the way from Romania. So yeah, so with that, we're going to conclude the session for the June. And let's meet up in the next month. Thank you everyone for joining. Have a good evening, good morning, or good afternoon.
Thank you. Bye.